In this video, we are going to see about the single phase induction motor. In that, we will see the double field revolving theory and why single phase induction motors are not self-starting and what is the speed torque characteristics of single phase induction motor. A single phase induction motor is given a single phase supply. It consists of a stator and rotor. The stator has a single phase winding and the rotor is similar to that of a three phase induction motor. A squirrel cage rotor is used. When we give the AC supply to the stator windings, an alternating field will be produced or an alternating flux will be produced. The alternating flux produced by the single phase induction motor cannot produce a torque when the rotor is stationary. However, in case of a three phase machine, if we give three phase supply to the stator winding, it will produce a rotating magnetic field. So, rotating magnetic field can produce a torque. Here we have only alternating field. So, this cannot produce a torque. So, we say that single phase induction motor is not self-starting. Double field revolving theory is used to prove that the alternating field cannot produce torque in the motor. So, according to this theory, any alternating quantity can be resolved into two components. For example, let us take phi m is the alternating quantity. It can be resolved into two components, phi m by 2 and phi m by 2. So, these two are equal in magnitude and these will be rotating at synchronous speed in opposite direction. Now, we will see this is the stator flux with a maximum magnitude of flux phi m. Let us draw the phasor diagram and this is the flux phi m. Now, according to this theory, flux can be resolved into two quantities, phi m by 2 and phi m by 2 in two opposite directions. Let us take this as A and this as B. So, A is equal to phi m by 2 and B is equal to phi m by 2. So, A is going in one direction and B in opposite direction. Now, this is the angle at theta equal to 0 degree. So, the resultant flux is phi m. Suppose, after some time, it might have rotated for some angle theta, A. Then, B will be rotating in opposite direction to the same angle theta, but in opposite direction. So, what will be the resultant flux now? So, phi resultant is given by 2 into phi m by 2, that is half of this, into cos theta. So, that is equal to phi m cos theta. Next, after some time, this will be rotating to this position and this will be moving to this position. That is, at every instant, we can calculate the resultant flux. So, here it is phi m by 2 and here it is phi m by 2. What will be the resultant flux? It will be 0 because both these fluxes are in opposite direction. So, 2 phi m by 2 into, because the angle is 90 degree here, cos 90 is 0. So, you will get 0. Next, if you see another position, let us take this 180 degree position. So, resultant flux will be minus phi m because 2 phi m by 2 into cos theta. Theta is 180, cos 180 is minus 1. So, you will get minus phi m. So, we can see that we are able to get a waveform of this pattern. That is, it is resembling a cos wave. So, it is maximum at 90 degree, it is 0. And again, it is going to minus phi m, then it will become 0, again go up. So, only an alternating flux is produced. So there are two fluxes. One is forward rotating flux, which rotates in the same direction as the rotor. Another one is backward rotating flux, so which rotates in the opposite direction. So let us calculate the slip. So what is slip? Slip is equal to ns minus n divided by ns. So forward rotating flux, the slip is sf is equal to s, because it is rotating in the same direction as rotor. That is equal to ns minus n divided by ns. So this is forward rotating slip. If we see the backward rotating slip, sb is equal to ns minus, what is n? Here it is minus n, because this backward rotating flux is rotating in a direction opposite to that of rotor. So it is minus n divided by ns, which will give you ns plus n divided by ns. So let us bring this equation in terms of slip. So for that, what I am going to do is I will add one ns and subtract the ns again. So I am adding and subtracting the same value so that the equation will not get disturbed. So here I am getting 2ns minus ns minus n divided by ns. So this is 2ns minus ns minus n divided by ns is nothing but slip. So if you simplify, you will get sb is equal to 2 minus s. So for forward rotating flux, slip is s. For backward rotating flux, slip is 2 minus s. Let us draw the speed torque characteristics. So there will be two torques, forward torque, which is due to the forward rotating flux, and another one backward torque, which is due to the flux in backward direction. So Tf is given by k into I2 square R2 by s. This will have a negative sign. Here slip is s and here slip is 2 minus s. Now at standstill condition, we know n is equal to 0. It means that standstill means motor is not rotating, so slip will be equal to 1. If s is equal to 1, what is this 2 minus s? 2 minus s is 2 minus 1, that is equal to 1. So both these value will be equal. So Tf equal to minus Tb at standstill condition. That is why when the motor is not rotating, forward torque is equal to minus of backward torque, or both are equal in magnitude but opposite in polarity. So net torque, if you see the speed torque characteristics here, when n is equal to 0, the resultant torque is 0, because both the torques are equal in opposite direction. So net torque is 0. That is why induction motor is not self-starting. But once it started by some other means, if we have some other value of slip here, these two magnitude will be different. So the motor will rotate in any one direction depending upon the values of the torque. So the resultant torque at other values, you will have resultant torque. Then how to make this induction motor to rotate? If I am giving some external force, or if I rotate it manually initially, then the motor will start to rotate. But that is not a fair method, or technically it is not correct. So what we can do is, we have to produce a rotating magnetic field. Induction motor normally produces only alternating field, but have to employ some method to make a rotating magnetic field. So this can be done by making the single phase motor work as a two phase motor. By having two windings, you can make it as a two phase motor and make it work. So the points to remember here are, the single phase induction motor has a single phase winding in its stator, and the rotor is similar to that of a squirrel cage, three phase squirrel cage induction motor. So when single phase AC supply is given, alternating flux will be produced. So single phase induction motor is not self starting. Thank you. If you like the video, do subscribe to Read Electric Vehicle channel. Thank you.